The original Super 73 came with a mid-drive motor. Like, how badass is that? I freaking love it. Here's a view of one that I caught live in public. Very rare to find, and they're worth a lot of money these days. But just so much power, you know? So much torque. I freaking love it. I wish they still made them this way. The cool thing is that I'm starting to see them more and more these days, out in the wild, if you will. I just went on a couple LA e-skate rides recently, and I saw a few of them. And one of them I did a video on already, and I'm gonna kind of bring another one to you today. The first one was from Urban Grizzly. His name's D, that's his YouTube channel, check it out. And he has one, and it has a 1,000-watt mid-drive, BAC 855 controller, putting out 4,000 watts. He has a 52-volt battery, and the 52-volt battery goes to the mid-drive, and the standard battery goes to the standard motor, which he has as well. So he has both of them running concurrently, and he's got all kinds of torque. Okay, so here's a guy with another one that I just found on a recent ride. So check this out.
Roadrunner?
Yeah.
Yeah, Kevin, right?
Novi.
Kevin.
Yeah, I remember.
It's like Novi or what's it called?
Novi.
What?
Novi, N-O-E.
Okay, no, yeah. So you put that on? Or you had that put on?
No, I put it.
Did you?
Yeah.
You run them both at the same time?
Yeah.
Wow, man. Oh, you have separate throttles.
Yeah, I
try
to take off, and it's just snapped on me right there.
Luckily you have the hub.
Yeah, so I'm trying to take it off.
Yeah. So what, that's a 1,000 watt?
3,000.
How much?
3,000.
Seriously? On a freaking Super 73?
Yeah.
So you got the stock,
and you got the mid-drive. I got another chain, man. I have extras.
Wow, so you had two chains?
Yeah.
Oh, that's badass. Wow, very cool. Look at those bikes, Jesus. No style with those. Look at this guy's hair. Boy. Is that purple? Skunk look? How big is that extra battery?
72 volt, 20 amp hour.
Does that run concurrent or run separately? I mean, do you run it at the same time?
Well, it's separate from this one.
Right, but do you run this one and then when this dies, then you do that one?
Well, I usually do it both at the same time.
Wow. You have insane power on that thing, huh?
Yeah.
Wow. 3,000 watt mid-drive. It's a shame it broke. Just need a chain, that's all.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about mid-drives. Mid-drives are smaller, they're lighter, but they're more expensive and they're way more powerful. I have a 750 watt mid-drive on a little Luna folding bike, and I actually have a scar on my left hand from when it just took off at an intersection and just blew out from under me. Because I forgot that you have to lean forward when you take off. There's just so much torque, and that's a 750 watt. So D for Urban Grizzly, he's got a 1,000 watt. And then Noe's got a 3,000 watt. Are you kidding me? The power of these freaking Super 73s, like Jesus. Anyway, I've caught both of them riding and taking off, and let's just take a look at them. Okay, here you see D just taking off right after I spoke to him. Literally, it's a Super 73, guys, and the thing just freaking takes off like a rocket. Like, I had to floor my bike, and I have a really powerful enduro just to keep up with him. Okay, here we have Noe. He's going to be coming up here on the left in a second. Watch this, guys. Well, watch him. There he goes. Ready? Wait for it. Bam! Look at him. He just takes off. That's like an 8 or 10% grade going up to the Griffith Observatory. My God, the man's gone. And then here he is in a different scenario. Ready? He's gonna be coming from the left. There he goes, ready? I'm already going probably 35 miles an hour, 40. Watch this. He just takes off. Watch him, he's leaning forward, wait for it. There he goes, look at that. Really? That's a Super 73. So that's his freaking 3,000 watt mid-drive. He's gone. I don't even see him anymore. Jesus Christ. My God. Okay, unfortunately, like all good things, there are some drawbacks, unfortunately, apparently, to having a mid-drive. Here's somebody on one of the forums has a Z1, Super 73 Z1, and he put a Cyclone kit on it, the same one that Noe did. And he says the only problem he's having is he keeps breaking chains. So, unfortunately, we have video of Noe doing just that.
Hey,
The hell's that? Somebody just dropped their freaking battery. That sounded pretty bad. I don't know what the hell that was. Oh, he's looking. What the hell was that? Oh, he busted a chain.
Very convenient.
What are you gonna do?
Pedal.
Unfortunately, when that happens, you're left having to walk or pedal. And the Super 73 is really hard to pedal, but you know what? It's probably worth the risk. So anyway, it just feels like we're coming full circle. I know there have been a bunch of mid-drives, I'm sure. I just hadn't seen any until recently. So to me, it's just kind of a really cool trend, and I would love to have one. I have a Super 73R, and I'd love to have a mid-drive on it, but gotta get somebody to put it on for you. Anyway, I thought you guys would enjoy this. Hope it helped give you some insight into what maybe you could do with your Super 73. And that's going to do it. Please like, please subscribe. God bless. Peace out.